Indie rocker Storm Large is a true force of nature, on stage and off. Storm and her two brothers grew up in Southborough, Massachusetts. Their mom, Susie, and father, Henry, were called the Golden Couple by friends. But that image quickly faded. Storm's mother had severe mental illness and was in and out of mental institutions. Fearing that she would inherit her mother's debilitating illness, Storm resorted to sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Thankfully, her music ended up saving her life. This powerhouse brought her larger-than-life talents to the stage of the reality competition show Rockstar Supernova in 2006. She went on to create an autobiographical one-woman show about her difficult life called Crazy Enough, and has penned a new, candid memoir with the same name. You remember that show Supernova in 2006? This very beautiful woman was on there, and she came in like third or fourth or fifth or whatever the hell. And you have gone on to have sort of an amazing career. I love your book.
Thank you.
It is so honest.
Thanks.
It's a memoir about what it's like to grow up in a family where mental illness is prevalent.
Yeah.
Your mom was sick from the time you can remember.
Yeah.
And your dad would tell you what about her absences?
Oh, when we were really little, it was mom's tired and she's resting in the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
So he was just doing what he knew best to do, which was to, there's a problem, don't tell the kids about it. We're just going to operate as if nothing's wrong, even though something is very, very wrong.
Okay, now you were the youngest of three?
Yes.
And you were how old when it started?
God, probably a year.
Yeah. And
yeah.
Was she ever really diagnosed with anything?
Everything.
Right, even back then?
There was a lot of, after I wrote the book especially, there's a lot of people have said, that was my mom, that was my dad, that was my aunt. They were very cavalier about how they diagnosed mental illness back then.
It
was manic depression, which is now bipolar. Mm-hmm. It was, she was psychotic, she was multiple personality, she was suicidal. It was all these different things that were just sort of thrown and medicated, and they were never right.
There's a beautiful part in the book, Storm, where you talk about the neighbors sort of just taking you in.
Yeah.
I totally related to that because, you know, my family, my mama died and there were five children, and the neighbors really did step in and treat us almost as their own kids. We would just eat dinner at someone else's house. And, and that, I love the word that you used for it, a momstitute.
Yeah, yeah.
Like a substitute, a momstitute.
Yeah, yeah. I had a few momstitutes and I was always on the lookout for new ones. And I guess a lot of women, when they have kids, they just sort of, this big mom gland starts pulsing, and it extends to a lot of their kids' friends. And thank God I had quite a few of those. And my friend Daphne's mom, Annie, was definitely one of those.
Did you covet the attention of the grown-ups, like the teachers at school? Did you?
No, actually, I just wanted to, I wanted people to like me. I wanted people to love me, and I just had this thing in me that there was something wrong with me, something's wrong with me, something's wrong with me. And if I could make somebody laugh, I'd be like, oh, okay, good. I've made you happy in my presence, so I'm going to be okay for just today.
Right.
Yeah.
You go through a lot of issues that you had in this book, and this was a one-woman show first.
Yeah.
How did the show come about? You were on stage, you were rocking, I read the whole thing and I loved it. You were in a band, you were in a bunch of bands, you had a lot of, you had hypersexuality.
Yeah.
You were with a lot of different people in different bands.
Yeah.
And then you sort of were on your own, and you came up with, I'm going to tell my truth while I sing my songs?
As a songwriter, I was never really a confessional songwriter, more metaphoric, but my stage banter is very brutally honest, and it's not, I wouldn't call myself a stand-up, I'm more of a cabaret storyteller, and hopefully it's funny, and hopefully it's reverent, but my director, I did a show did cabaret in Portland Center Stage.
Playing Sally Bowles.
Sally Bowles.
Fantastic.
And it was amazing. My director, Chris Coleman, at Portland Center Stage, was talking to me about the role, and I said, well, you know, she's a dirty club singer that feels unloved, and she does drugs, and she has sex irresponsibly, and that's pretty appropriate for me, so I could do it. And so that led to more conversations about my life and my background, and he said, you know, you should write a one-woman show about your life. And I'm like, Yeah, I could sex, drugs, and rock and roll. He goes, no, it should be about your mom.
Well, that's what it's really about. It's not about sex, drugs, rock and roll. It's about a mother who's very ill and a daughter who's trying to figure out how to live in spite of that truth.
Right.
There's a scene where you go to the hospital. You're 9 or 10 years old, and your mother is quite ill, and the doctor comes over to you, and you ask the doctor what?
Well, I was just trying to make conversation, and I said, well, that's not going to happen to me, right? And he very casually said, well, yeah, you are going to end up exactly like your mother. You know, it's hereditary. But he meant it. It's a monstrous and irresponsible thing to say.
You're not kidding.
But he meant it, I think. That's still the common thinking, that it follows along bloodlines.
Well, there is hereditary. Yeah. And mental illness is in some way hereditary, right. But it's not definitive.
No, it's not. It's not in stone that what comes from the parents, other than eye color, hair color, you know, other genetics. But, you know, addiction is got genetic connections. But he wasn't trying to be a jerk. He just was saying what was commonly known. But it was an adult saying something out loud that I had always believed. So
very sad, that part. Yeah. And I think irresponsible of him. But we're going to take a break, come back, and we're going to talk about Storm's mom and her life and what perhaps led to all the struggles she had. We'll be back. Storm Large, and the book is Crazy Enough. And if you haven't read it, you should, because it's fantastic.